those three ideas put in that perspective, I got an introduction, I've got a meat or body of the drum solo, and then I've got my climactic wow factor over here. That's kind of like baking in the ingredients that are going to help me execute it. Motivational curve. To construct that drum solo, one of the opening ideas I had was like this Iko Iko type of groove or pattern. And I'm going to put that as one of them. Kind of saying like, hey, little part that I like, I'm going to stay with you for a little while. You know, I'm just going to hang out with you, check you out, you know. I'm going to be with you. I'm going to sing to you. I'm going to water you. I'm going to put you near the window. I'm going to shine a light on you and watch you grow. Okay, that's a good one. That's a recent groove that I like, an idea that I like. I'll call it because it's got a double clap. All over. They're just going to take him out. And here come the Cracker Monsters. Couldn't shoot him back, so all of a sudden the Cracker Monster yelled at the other Cracker Monster and kicked the gun closer to him. And all of a sudden the hero could reach the gun. He grabbed the gun, then all of a sudden he shot the Cracker Monster. Then... making it extreme. What would be more extreme than making a mistake once, three times in a row? Call that the off tom. That's my name game, but that's how I remember that whole part. If you're asking about how to construct a drum solo, I'm going to say go with your biggest bang in the last section and escalate it to a frenzy with a big ta-da. Saves the princess and the CEO goes down with the Cracker Monster. Then boom, they're right off into the sunset with a record contract. Here's the important thing. The only thing you got to worry about. It's an idea that you like. Something that you've already played or messed with that you enjoy.